New pictures just into CNN. A group of armed Trump supporters gathered outside the FBI office in Phoenix, Arizona. Photographs taken this morning show Trump supporters carrying handguns and assault-style weapons on the street. That is allowed under Arizona's open carry law. One of the demonstrators said they're at that location to support Trump and protest what they call the unlawful search at Mar-a-Lago. Now, this week, the FBI, along with the Department of Homeland Security, issued a joint intelligence bulletin warning of violent threats against federal law enforcement, courts, and government personnel, as well as facilities.
Following the FBI search of Mar-a-Lago, the Bureau is monitoring an unprecedented number of threats fueled by dangerous statements like these.
This is Gestapo crap, and it will not stand. The Department of Injustice needs to be cleaned out if they are going to start pretending we're some sort of banana republic.
This should scare the living daylights out of American citizens and say, we have got to change our federal government. The way our federal government has gone, it's like what we thought about the Gestapo and people like that, that they just go after people. What we thought about Soviet Union, what we look at Latin America, we have got to say to ourselves, this cannot be our country.
Just yesterday, the names of the two agents who signed the search warrant paperwork were circulating online after the unredacted warrant was leaked. Joining me now is Peter Strzok. He is a former FBI counterintelligence official who played a central role in both the Hillary Clinton email and Trump-Russia investigations. He's also the author of Compromised, Counterintelligence and the Threat of Donald J. Trump. Peter, one of the most amusing things that I saw in the past week, I think I saw one Republican lawmaker saying, well, where was all the attention to Hillary Clinton's emails? Of course, I remember when James Comey came out with that 11 days before the 2016 election, had a very big impact on that election. But what do you say to those voices on the far right who spent all week slamming the Bureau's integrity and really using the kind of language that could lead to violence, could animate some extremists out there who might be thinking about doing something violent?
Yeah, grow up. This is wildly irresponsible. This is directly leading to violence. It is inflaming people. It is causing things like a gunman approaching the Cincinnati field office of the FBI, brandishing a weapon, leading people on a car chase and, you know, ending in his death. This is something we know from decades of the global war on terror, the things that you try and do to de-radicalize people. You approach political leaders, community leaders, faith leaders, and you tell them to dial back the rhetoric. What we're seeing in America today is the opposite. And, you know, to your point, with a team of about 20 people, I spent a year and a half working on Hillary Clinton's email server, where we executed multiple search warrants. I never heard one Republican once raise a finger talking about how we were using Gestapo tactics or overreaching. In from the Democrats, behaving like responsible American citizens, letting the FBI do its job. And that's what the Republicans need to do here. The FBI has a job to do to enforce the laws of the United States. And it's beyond the pale that there are senators, United States senators, who are going along and nodding their head up and down with suggestions that the FBI plants evidence are things which are extraordinarily wrong. And these people know better. And for them to be continuing to say that, in light of everything we're now seeing, the constant flow of classified material that's being recovered out of Mar-a-Lago, false statements apparently by attorneys to President Trump saying that that nothing remained, there isn't any basis to be making these claims. It is leading to violence and it needs to stop.
Yeah, it almost reminds me, Peter, of some of the incendiary rhetoric that we heard leading up to January 6th. And we saw, of course, that spasm of violence on that day, which obviously is the subject of the January 6th investigation. And all of that is not really on the front page right now because we're focusing so much on what occurred at Mar-a-Lago a few days ago. But let's just clear something up. If it were any other person not named Trump, who had 11 sets of classified documents at their home, including items marked top secret SCI, how would you be treated by the FBI? I mean, it's almost because Trump goes after people, he engages in character assassination, he's gone after you, for example, and so on, that the Justice Department, the FBI, correct me if I'm wrong here, they do, I guess, treat the former president somewhat carefully because of what he can unleash.
Right. And I think, you know, Trump has a history of playing in the margins of legality. He finds where that line is, he goes right up to it, and he pushes it to see whether or not he can get away with something. That was magnified when he became president, just because of the history of deference we have in this country to the presidency. So things which were never really codified, things that were always accepted as common practice, he walked right past that. And whether it was disregarding questions that Special Counsel Mueller asked of him, refusing to be interviewed in person, whether it's things like this where he's claiming first that he didn't have documents, then that he turned them in, then that he declassified them. There's just nothing there that, you know, he won't push the boundary. Now, when it comes to my experience, I know from personal experience, several very high-level, high-ranking government officials that I was present executing a search warrant because there was no offer of a subpoena. There was no reach out to their attorney to try and negotiate the return of something which we suspected they had. If they had classified information and they didn't have authorization to have it, it was contraband. We went to a judge, we got a search warrant, we executed that and recovered the material. So there's just no question in my mind that Trump is being treated differently, and largely because of who he is, but also because of his position as a former president.
And Peter, here's a question that I have that has not been answered, and that is, why is a former president of the United States in possession of all of this top secret material? Do all of our former presidents have mansions and resort properties where they keep a room full of top secret classified material? I mean, why does he have this stuff?
Jim, he's an outlier. There is nobody else, no other president that I'm aware of. And certainly when I was an FBI agent, there is no other president in my experience that ever had classified information, let alone this volume. What troubles me the most about this case, I cannot understand why he maintained that material. The intelligence community struggled on a daily, day in, day out basis to try and get him to pay attention to the president's daily brief. They tried and struggled to get him to listen to the intelligence community. He was happy to listen to Vladimir Putin, but he had no appetite to sit and listen to what it was that folks within the intel community were trying to tell him. Now, suddenly, he's out of office, and he suddenly pivots to take 27 boxes of classified material that he couldn't be bothered to read while he was the president. He's not writing some detailed memoir about, you know, the political ins and outs of what he accomplished in the Middle East or with North Korea. It makes no sense why he would keep it. And that really, when you look at what it is that he appears to have had, that is really, really troubling.
Yeah, Peter, I mean, the former president, he's put out all kinds of fundraising emails in the last several days. He's put out lots of statements and posts on his Truth Social website. We haven't heard, why does he have this stuff? And, you know, if he or his people are listening, can they just offer that explanation? Why do they have all this top secret material at Mar-a-Lago? I think it's a question that needs to be answered. Peter Strzok, thank you very much for your time. We appreciate it.